successfully to breathe. Abdominal efforts by the mother or by her attenders produce no advance. Gentle head traction is equally unavailing. Usually equanimity forsakes the attendants. They push, they pull. Alarm increases, eventually by greater strength of muscles or by some infernal juggle. The difficulty appears to be overcome and the shoulders and trunk of a goodly child are delivered. The pallor of its body contrasts with the plum-colored cyanosis of the face and the small quantity of fleshly expelled meconium about the buttocks. It dawns upon the attendants that their anxiety was not ill-founded. The baby lies limp and voiceless and only too often remains so despite all efforts and resuscitation. It is a very old picture cut out from J. Morris from the British Empire, 1955. And this is the usual scenario of a shoulder dystocia baby being delivered. It not only disappoints the parents, but it produces a lot of mental catastrophe and agony to the delivering obstetrician. Diagnosis of shoulder dystocia is ill done. We always depend on something called as a turtle sign, and the turtle sign is actually a warning sign. It is not a diagnostic sign. Diagnostic sign should be something which tells us before the problem occurs, but turtle sign is something where the shoulder dystocia has happened and then it warns us that there is an impending shoulder dystocia, and then we're not left with much time to react. Head to completion of delivery interval of more than 60 seconds is usual, and we need to use additional maneuvers to deliver the shoulders, and hence diagnosis of shoulder dystocia often strikes us as an emergent situation rather than you cannot predicting it a little earlier is difficult. Fetopelvic relationships is something which we need to understand the basics. Three diameters of the pelvic inlet or the brim, of which the anteroposterior diameter is the narrowest. The bisacromial diameter, that is the shoulder diameter, is more than the bipartite diameter of the head. So, if the bisacromial diameter is large, the shoulders confront the narrow anteroposterior diameter of the pelvic brim and thereby produces dystocia. The dystocia could be unilateral or bilateral.